Okay. Hello everyone, welcome to the computer science department. My name is Vihari Paratla. I am a third year PhD student here in this department. First I will start with a brief summary and will tell you a little bit about computer science department, and thereafter they are going to tell you in the subsequent presentations, they are going to tell you in depth about the kind of research that happens in our department. At the moment, the computer science department here has 42 full-time faculty, and we admit more than 130 students per year into the bachelor's program, and more than 100 students per year into master's program. And the PhD strength in aggregate at the moment is around 100. And we are also rolling out a new MS by research program starting from 2020. As you are probably aware of, IIT Bombay computer science department is the most sought out by the top rankers in the respective examinations, either it is a JEE or the GATE, and that is not without a reason. We have several things to take pride in. We have a Padma Sri award in our faculty, Professor D. Patak, and we have an Infosys Foundation award winner, Professor Sunita Saravagi, and we have two Santhiswarup Bhatnagar award winners, Professor Soman Chakrabarti and Professor Ashwin Gumaste. And we have several ACM and IEEE fellows and editors of international journals in our faculty. And our research scholars are no less. We have been awarded ACM India Doctoral Dissertation Award in 2012 and 14, and a honorable mention in 2020. The alumni from our department go out into these leading research labs, that includes IIT. We do IIT Bombay, the computer science department here is one of the premier research institutions in the globe, and we do active research in almost all the major areas of computer science. That includes artificial intelligence, machine learning, natural language processing, image processing, theory, systems, programming languages and databases. We produce more than 100 research publications an year at top international venues. In aggregate, the research papers that we have written have garnered more than 37,000 citations. That is, other research papers have referred to the papers written in our department more than 37,000 times in the last 5 years. And in our faculty, we have some of the most highly cited authors from India. And the research here has active participation from research scholars, masters and bachelor students. The research projects are sponsored either by the government or interested third party companies like Google, VMware, IBM, TCS, Amazon, etc. We get an approximate of 50 to 60 crores per year as the funding for the research. And we do research in almost all the major areas of computer science. That includes artificial intelligence and several others that are listed here. And our faculty have written several textbooks which have made into the part of curriculum in several parts of the world. That reflecting the technical expertise of the faculty in their respective fields. IIT Bombay is also, the computer science department here is also very active in taking up service initiatives. We play an active role in National Mission on Education through ICT. We conduct online interactive workshops at 385 remote centers, and the courses offered through this initiative reach up to 10,000 teachers, thereby enhancing the quality of engineering education across the country. We also roll out actively the online courses through edX or NPTEL. We also have an in-house outreach program called eYantra, and in the subsequent presentations we will go more in detail about what eYantra is about. Thank you. I can take any questions. If
you talk more about They are planning to roll out as a mini PhD program. It can last from 1.5 years to 3 years. So it has a dissertation and has a more focus into PhD. So it has a thesis. It's more research oriented than a master's program. That's what the MS by research is.
So how do I get?
So you can find a lot more details around February on the IIT website. But it's just like a
okay. Hi, my name is Kavi Arya. I am a professor in this department in embedded systems. This is a project called eYantra, which came out of the teaching of embedded systems. When we tried to teach this subject to a large number of students across the distance education program, I tried to do this in 2002. It was an utter failure because distance education was very good at transmitting theoretical knowledge. How do you transmit practical knowledge of building stuff, making engineering artifacts and stuff like that? It didn't work very well. So I thought at that time, why don't we think of a lab in a box that we can give to students, and by doing assignments on that box, they can learn stuff. So that's when we came up with this idea of building a robot, which we developed over 5 years. So now that robot has turned into a platform, and we have a project called eYantra, which was funded by the government, which has been running for the last 10 years, where we've been using this robot-based, platform-based methodology for teaching large numbers of students remotely and teaching them very complex skills, right? So what this talk is about, so we have about almost 1 million engineers who graduate every year, right? So we want to tackle big problems, okay? 1 million engineers, they are generally a good quality resource. Just because he's come to IIT or she comes to IIT, it doesn't mean that they are that great, right? There's a lot of talent which is out there, which does not realize its potential, which does not fulfill its potential because of inadequate training and lack of exposure to practical knowledge, practical based skills, right? And if you can just kind of, you know, train them, retrain them in practical skills, you can create huge opportunities for them for placements and for startups and all that kind of stuff. So that is the project of ours, problem that we are looking at. So these are the skills we need to teach them, right? How to investigate a problem, a real world problem, how do you design a solution, usage of modern tools, how to work as a team, communication skills and all that. Most of our engineers unfortunately don't realize the importance of communication skills. Simple things like writing proper documents, presenting yourself articulately, right? Communicating with each other. They don't realize, they think this is just soft skills. They don't realize its importance. But when you are outside in the world, your engineering stands for just 10%. 80 to 90% is how well you communicate your skills, communicate problems, and can work with other people to solve problems. Okay, so we have a way to do that. Sorry. This is the robot that we developed in-house. Now we've outsourced it to a company to sell this. The design is basically a platform, right? I used to go to colleges. Students want to do a robotic project, but market mein robot nahi milta hai. So they have to build a robot from scratch to do a robotic application. And so they spend 1 year trying to build a robot. And at the end of a year, I don't know, maybe you've seen your friends do this. They have a half-built robot which they give their guide and they go out, and again the same thing happens next year. So we designed a platform, which is a platform on wheels which has lots of sensors, actuators, this, that and the other. And this can be used to build a solution, to build a machine, iske aadhar pe, using this as a platform. A machine which will take you about a year to build otherwise, if you built it from scratch using controllers and sensors and interfacing it yourself. You can build it using this within 1 month, and we are confident of that because for the last 10 years students have been doing projects in my embedded systems course where within 1 month they can build some really cool machines. Okay, so now what we do is that we've taken this know-how of ours And we've packaged it into a competition because students love competitions, right? So we first tried to teach lots of teachers. It didn't work too well. We trained 700 teachers over 35 workshops in 2 years, and we thought we'll cause a revolution. Nothing happens. Then we realized it's something deeper. Let's work with students. So we packaged our knowledge as a competition, and we were amazed at what students are capable of. So this is what students have to say about us.
IIT has taught me a lot of lessons in life, and I have dedicated 6 months of my life to this competition. And boy, I wouldn't have learned anything more in any other competition or any other place. This journey molded me into an engineer. Before, I used to only write record and assignments, but during this journey of IIT, it has made me realize that practical knowledge is the utmost importance. There's nothing greater than practical knowledge, and it has put me in so many pressure conditions, so many deadlines, that I don't feel pressured at all. So during my exams, I'm a very cool guy now. And it has taught me a lot of lessons about teamwork, about time management, and about handling people and handling resources, which I would have never learned anywhere else.
Before IIT, I think I was very lazy, and after IIT, I think there's a lot of change, there's a lot of improvement in me. I remember there were like 10 days where we didn't know how the days went, and that too it was during New Year time, so we were actually spending our New Year with working in IIT. We were going to get the parts, like our bot parts fabricated. So we were going through a metro, so in a hurry I was just climbing the stairs, and I just injured my leg. So 3 days later we had I could have sat at home, but I was so passionate that I just ignored the pain, and I just came and attended the finals.
So that gives you an idea of what students learn. They discover passion, right, which they never had the opportunity to, and by working really hard, focused way, along with balancing their academics, they come up with insights about themselves, and at the end of the journey, they are very empowered. In fact, 2 weeks ago, a student wrote to me that they've done a startup based on the same skills we've taught them in the competition. He's done a startup. One of the themes in the competition is how to build a control system for a drone, right? How do you make a drone hover and then move it from place to place? He's used those same skills in doing a startup where he's got this company that makes a drone that surveys a mine. That means you give it geographical points on a map, it will find the boundary of the area, it will divide it up into strips, and his drone will autonomously navigate, go and cover those strips, taking a video record of the whole thing. Beech mein, if the battery runs out, it autonomously goes back, lands, recharges, goes back and continues the work. That's mind-blowing, and that's what these kids are able to do because of the skills that they've learned. So he is one guy who leads it, and 4 other chaps who are all IIT-rics, we like to call them now. Okay, so that's the difference it's causing out there. Okay, this is how the numbers have grown in the competition, from almost 4,000 in 2012 to 34,170 whatever, right, this last year. And almost 900 colleges are taking part. So obviously students are getting a lot of useful gyan out of this whole thing, okay. And each year we have more and more difficult skills, because some students come in the first year, second year, third year, fourth year. So for the more experienced ones, we have more difficult themes. So this was a theme in which they had to conceptualize an autonomous snake robot. They had to model it using open source tools. They had to simulate it using open source tools. Once we are happy with that, we give them a budget. They print a small part of the snake and show us how they will integrate the electronics and all that. If we like that, they print the entire snake and solve the problem, right? So this gives you an idea of the complexity. Why isn't this working? Okay. So this is a snake. it has to avoid all the obstacles on the arena, and it has to find the rodents, which are those different colored patches, right? And it has to overcome those ramps, and the ones which can do it in the least time, most accurately, is the winner. And there's a formula, very objective way that we evaluate this thing. So this shows you the skills these guys have acquired in 6 months' time on their own at a distance, right, through coaching from us here. So that's what students are learning, these kind of complex skills, 3D modeling, electronics, interfacing, and they do it typically in teams of four, typically multidisciplinary teams. One chap can be from mechanical, from engineering, from computer science, you know, those kind of things. And we had a game, we called them all to the finals at IIT Bombay, and then we had this. Do I have to do the same here? These are five different or six different snake designs, because out of each theme, the top 5 to 6 teams come to IIT Bombay, where an IIT Bombay faculty jury evaluates them. Note, the pointer is not working too well. There's a snake here on the top left hand side. You see it there, this one here, which is moving like a real snake. The others are moving like a caterpillar. Okay. That top left hand one. Yes. So the snakes have to go to the middle and pick up that diamond which has a magnet on it, and the snake's head also has a magnet on it. See what it's doing? This snake in the foreground here has a skin, and if it turns upside down, it can right itself. See, it's got it. Now the really cool thing about this is, would you believe it, the team that came to the finals, that team there, was a team from APC Rai Polytechnic in West Bengal. Four polytechnic boys, right, beat the hell out of all these other kids from NITs and well-to-do colleges and stuff like that, which shows us that our competition is really democratic. Unlike other competitions like Robocon and all that, where you need a big budget to compete and your college has to invest lots of money and you have large teams of 35 people, our competition is four people totally empowered by us, and if they have the will, the ability and the grit and persistence, that's the kind of stuff they can do. And we were amazed at this. This shows that our competition is democratic. It also shows us how unfortunate our system, education system, is, that it uses only exams to evaluate students. These guys would not be even given a Vodafone sales executive job. Wo log bolega polytechnic ka hai vagera. But the fact is, these guys have shown such amazing skills. Okay, so something else which is very interesting, now we are trying to create places where these skills can continue. So once we teach a college, the skill will remain inside there and grow. So we have this idea of eYantra labs, right? If a college is willing to invest 2 lakhs of rupees in its own lab, means its own equipment, if it's willing to give 4 teachers to be trained, that's all you need to do. Don't give me any money. Give me 4 teachers to be trained. We will train them at our cost over 2 to 3 months, and you buy the equipment. After that, we inaugurate the lab. And we find that the completion rate of the competition shows you how skilled your students are, right? Typically, we find that the completion rate of students in the competition completing all the tasks is about 5%. But for students from colleges which have a lab, the completion rate is almost 9.5 to 10%, right? So double the completion rate. So having a lab creates a change of culture in a college and improves their technical ability. So we have almost 370 plus labs in the whole of India. The number is growing. And we have an ideas competition through which we teach innovation and entrepreneurship and things like that. Those numbers have also been growing over the last few years. And I won't go into this other video, but this is how we are really affecting students. We gave them a survey. They responded. We put everything into a word cloud. We are affecting their self-confidence. We are affecting their technical skills. We are affecting their problem-solving abilities and cool things like that. Right? So in summary, jobs are in very short supply. Machine learning, AI is going to reduce jobs even more across all verticals, across healthcare, manufacturing, software, what have you. All those ghodagiri and low-skilled jobs will disappear, and jobs are not going to increase so much. The Western economies are also contracting. So what is the answer for this almost half our population which is below the age of 25? Where will you find jobs for them? We find the only answer is entrepreneurship, because our economy is growing so fast, it's growing exponentially, right? That means it took us 60 years to become $1 trillion. Then it took us 7 years to become $2 trillion. Then it took us 3 years. Now we are almost $3 trillion. So people have more money in their pockets. They're willing to buy things that your parents would never even have thought of. And you can only meet the requirements of this growing population, this population which is growing in wealth also. You can only meet the requirements by having lots of automation, right? So, but who will build this automation, right? So we feel that the students are there, we need to equip them with the skills, and they are going to do it all, right? So huge opportunity. Our Indian economy is growing. We need novel products and services and things like that. We see problems as opportunities. And as Amitabh Bachchan said in Padman, that film, right? He said, don't think of us as 1.3 billion mouths to feed, 1.3 billion minds which can engage in Avishkar. So that's where we are. We are trying to build these innovation ecosystems at scale, right? So in the computer science department, almost 35 youngsters who are no different from you young engineers are running the entire project. Our average age is 23. You take me out, it'll become 21, right? And they're doing everything. And it just shows how capable young people are if they apply their minds to it. And a lot of research papers are coming out of it. So if you go to our stall here, you'll see a lot of technology we have created whilst solving this bigger problem, which also shows you that if you take on a noble cause, a big problem, research happens, by the way, as a process, right? So that's my encouragement to all of you. Think of something big that you want to do, right? And everything will come out of that. Be passionate about things. And we've discovered that we are just empowering students by giving them opportunities and giving them an environment where they can be passionate, and they do some really cool stuff. Anyway, I'll stop here. Any questions? How many of you had heard of IIT before? You had? Which college are you from?
RSC.
Where is that? Okay. Do you have a lab in your college? We should have one. How about you guys? Did you hear about IIT? You had? Okay. You guys? Okay, you are from here. So anyway, any questions? Good, thank you. Who's next?
This is Lohit, my colleague from the project. And if your friends will be coming here tomorrow and day after, they'll be seeing him. And you can ask him anything you like.
Hello everyone, I'm Megha Agarwal, final year M.Tech student, doing my project under Professor S. Sudarshan, and we are working on the project Kawak artifact checking system. So as we all know that fake news has become a problem in today's era, and the platform social media is used mostly, like WhatsApp, Facebook or Twitter. People share the news without even verifying it, like they just share it without any proof. And the main motive behind fake news is like to cause monetary benefits or to defame other person or to cause a sense of disbelief among people. Like there was a news recently that 2000 notes will be banned. So we are working on the area so that we can reduce such kind of news spread. So we are working, basically we all know in India what we have observed is WhatsApp is the main platform where news are being spread. So how can a user fact check a forward? So there are many ways, like there are many fact checking sites like Alt News, Check for Spam, Boom Live, Alt News. So what they do is they manually fact check the articles, but that requires a human effort. And there are many AI based systems also. So what they do is, given a claim, they will say whether it is true or false. But what we want to provide is, we want to provide user enough proof so that he or she can believe, okay, this is true or not. And you can do Google search also, but there's a limit on that. It will take only 30 words from the query, whatever you are giving, and then it will search the video, the text. So the goal of our Kawakate fake news detection project is to make it easy for the users to get the information. And we are handling images and videos as well, because we all know to make your news more believable, you will share some kind of media like a image or the video, so that people can believe, okay, this is a image, that means this is true. So we are handling that cases as well. So these are the interfaces which we are handling, which we have. We have a web app and a mobile app and a WhatsApp number. So you can send your query to the WhatsApp number, or you can install our app and check that query on our app, or you can use the web app. We will give you a demo after this presentation. And we have a dashboard as well for the journalist. So we want to monitor what kind of queries we are getting and which queries more frequent. So whenever you will send a message to us on the WhatsApp, that will be displayed here, and we will know, okay, this is the, and we are clubbing all those together, and we will know, okay, this is the most searched query right now. So that, in that way, we have a backend as well. So this is our Kawakate architecture. So what we have a chatbot, web and mobile app, and then we have a backend. So that will, we will pass our query to the backend, and then it will process. We are crawling multiple sites. We are crawling fact-checking sites, like I have told you, Alt News, Boom Live, Check for Spam. We are crawling and we are creating our own data set. So that what happens is, going further, we will use that data set to do more processing, like bias detection. Okay, Times of India is biased towards which party, Congress or BJP? Like that, we are creating a data set, because we found out that right now there is no data set available for Indian context. We found data set for American news sites, but not for Indian context. So we are trying to build that. So there are many multiple sites doing that, like Google Fact Check API. Recently it is there. But what, similarly, there is a limit on the words from which you can search, and altnews.in, but these sites are specific to their work only. Altnews will display their work only. Here we are displaying all the sites' work, and we have combined all the sites here. So thank you, we'll give you the demo. Saurabh will give you the demo.
So this is our web app. So as you can see, we can search anything, any WhatsApp forward or anything you get in this text box, and we can return queries from here. So all the recent articles which have the keyword India will be searched here. So let's say you have a WhatsApp forward which says something like RBI will be discontinuing 2000 rupees banknotes, and you paste the text here. So this is all you get. We have crawled various sites like Alt News, Check for Spam, Boom Life, and they all have already falsified this claim. So you can also see the original article here. Right. We also handle claims which have an image, such as this example of a man pelting stones. This image was also circulated over WhatsApp, and as you can see, Alt News has already falsified this claim too. So suppose somebody sends you a screenshot of a news which looks like this image here. The headline says Saudi man accidentally buys two Airbus A350s for son's birthday. So when I click on this, various people have already falsified this claim, Alt News, AFP and Check for Spam, Boom Live. And we also have a web app. We also have a mobile client. So as you can see, this is our fake news hotline WhatsApp number. You can forward any of your messages here, and shortly, in a span of 2 to 3 minutes, you'll get a reply from our bot, which says, which crawls the web for relating queries and tells you if that query is false or true, or if it cannot find it, it tells you that when our volunteers find any related articles or can falsify or falsify the claim, they'll get back to you. You can check out our WhatsApp number here. Yeah, you can test your own queries here, and that's it. Thank you. And
So you can use this number, or you can install our app from the Play Store, Cover Gate Fact Check app, or you can log in, browse kkfactcheck.in. I'll just show that, kkfactcheck.in. So you can you'll find our interface there. If you have any questions, you can ask. No questions. Thank you.